Should couples split the bills 50-50? Now, in this video, guys, I am going to be talking about this issue around relationships and finances. And this is a topic that is very controversial.
So what's your thought on finances?
I think that's a conversation that, you know, one would have. I think, you know, we split the mortgage. I would take water, cable, internet. Maybe she handles the car insurance.
So it's about splitting everything.
You know, being partners with it.
So I know we're going to have lots of people with different opinions, some for it, some against it. And that is equally, on both levels, correct. The real thing here, I think, is couples need to be talking about finances early in their dating. Like, I do not believe that you should be waiting until you get married to start having those conversations. No way. You need to be actually having those conversations as part of really the data that you're gathering on that person. This is part of the dating process. It's all about gathering that information. Okay, what's their viewpoint on finances? Where are their finances now? And it's not kind of doing it as a tick box exercise, like, okay, what's your credit report? And what's your, you're weaving these things into the conversation early. And this is important because if you are a woman who is all about a man paying the mortgage in full, okay, then you need to really make sure that that is communicated quite early, just like the man should be communicating what his viewpoints are when it comes to finances. The downside here is that most people, when they get dating, don't do this. They're looking at eyes, curves, biceps, triceps, bum, breasts, all these other things that are great. We need physical attraction, but there's even more attraction sometimes gained when we start to see that visions align. And these are the things that really spark interest in people. This leads me to the second point about growth as a couple. Now, if you are in a stage in your life where maybe you are in your 30s, in your 40s, and you maybe are already established, you already have a home, maybe that you've bought or maybe that you rent, you already have an income that is quite solid and stable and consistent. If you've already got some of those foundations, you are in a different position to someone who might just be starting out in this dating game. Where are you at in your life? Where am I at in my life? And can it align? Is there somewhere where we can unify on a vision that we're moving forward with our finances? And in this example here, we've got Chris. And Chris, maybe, rightly or wrongly, he's assumed that Nyya makes more money than him.
I know she makes more than me, because, you know, ain't no money in Reddit.
But what I think happened here is Chris felt intimidated, potentially, by Nyya. So what he done is he kind of backtracked into that place of, okay, I don't think your lifestyle and maybe your house might be outside of my budget. This is all perception.
I have no problem with falling back and letting her shine. I know my place.
So I'm just gonna fall back. I'm happy for you to shine, babe. Shine bright, shine, shine. No. What you should have done maybe is had that conversation to say, you know what? This is something me and Nyya will talk about. My view on it is that actually I would like to be able to provide where there's space for two people to partner and grow. Now, if you're a woman who is not looking for growing with someone, creating your empire together, building from the ground up, then you are gonna probably be looking for a guy who is saying, I'm established and maybe I'm happy to cover everything. But I always say, be very careful. Ladies, when we want, or we say we want that type of person, yes, there can be some benefits of relinquishing financial control to someone where it comes to covering a mortgage and a rent. But you might not just be relinquishing some financial control. You might find that actually you've relinquished your voice in that conversation, in that family. So I always say to people, be very mindful, because there are people out there who will financially abuse you. There are people who will also try and dominate. I always say, if you've got a confidence to you, if you've got the ability to say, listen, this is me and this is what I bring to the table. Whether it's £10 an hour that you make, or whether it's you make 100K a year or more, You have to come there with an air of confidence that says, this is who I am. Accept me or don't. You, as an individual, have to be willing to come to those conversations honest, open, and ready to say, this is my position. This is what I have to offer. It doesn't mean I'm not willing to put in extra work, because Chris is someone, he probably would have went and got a second job, third job, fourth job, just to make sure Nyya and that baby were probably comfortable. We may never know now, who knows? But what I am saying is, when it comes to these conversations around finances, don't feel like you have to say things you can't do, but do be open to making sure that person knows that I might not right now be at that position, but this is what I bring. This is my vision for where I'm trying to get to, and allow that person to make an assessment whether it fits or whether it doesn't. Anyway, guys, those are just a few of my thoughts when it comes to finances and relationships and whether you split or don't split. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Are you someone who's all about 50-50, or are you someone who's all about that person, the man, needs to pay for everything? Guys, make sure you hit the like button, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss a video each and every time I upload. Take care and God bless. Bye.